Hey guys, I'm Akshay and welcome to AppDNA, where we talk about all things apps. So last time we took a look at an education management application and attendance management application. This time we're going to take a look at something that belongs to the same niche, which is schooling. So when we hear about school, the first thing that comes to our mind are grades, courses, events, subjects, etc. And this particular app is focused on managing all of these. The application focuses on allotting classes, subjects and students to faculties, communication within the school and with the parents, and also will help in managing class timetables. Before we delve into the application in detail, let's take a look at the four major roles that will benefit the most from implementing this application. They are the admin, teachers, students and parents. The admin is the one who has got a holistic view of the application. He'll be able to add students, add employees, and will also be able to send email notifications and announcements. The parents will be able to receive all the notifications from the school side. The teachers and students will be able to keep track of all the grades and subjects assigned to them. We'll be building the application with Zoho Creator, which is a low-code application development platform. The easy-to-use interface, minimal coding, and drag-and-drop features will help us make the application quick and easy. Let's get started.
Application page of Zoho Creator, and we'll be creating the application from scratch. Let's name our application as Schooling 101. Here we are at the builder where we'll be creating new forms. So let's create our first form, which is the Add Academic Year form. We'll be dragging and dropping one single line field to record the academic year. We'll be doing the same for department as well. Now it's time for us to create a database for subjects. So we'll be creating the add subject form. We'll be dragging and dropping a lookup field to collect information about the department. Now we'll be dragging and dropping a single line field for subject name. We'll be creating the add teacher form next. So we already have a database of academic year, department and subjects. We need to create databases for teachers and students as well. We'll be dragging and dropping name, which is a basic field. We'll also be dragging and dropping two lookup fields for department and subject names. We'll also be dragging and dropping the email field to collect the email ID of the teachers. To create is the add students form, where we'll be collecting information about the students as well as the parents. At first, let's create fields that will help us collect the basic information such as name, date of birth, gender, email, etc. of the students. Now we'll be adding a notes field so that we'll be able to segregate the information between that of the students and that of the parents. We could also add a subform and collect the details of the parents in the subform. We'll be dragging and dropping the name field, email field, and a single line field to mark the relationship between the student and the parent. Now it's time for us to create the next basic form, which is the add grade form. We'll be dragging and dropping a lookup field to collect the academic year. We'll also be dragging and dropping a single line field to collect the grade. We'll be dragging and dropping two lookup fields, one to collect the subject information and the other to get the student names. The next form that we are going to create is allot subjects to teachers. So here we'll be mapping the grades, subjects and teachers with each other. So we'll be creating a form. We'll be dragging and dropping three lookup fields for grade, subject, and teacher. The next form that we are going to create is almost like a backbone of this application, which is the create timetable form. We'll be dragging and dropping two lookup fields for academic year and grade. Academic year. We'll also be dragging and dropping two date time fields for from and to. Now we'll be drag and dropping another lookup field for subjects. And now we'll be dragging and dropping a drop down field to select the day of the week. So we'll be naming the field as day, and we'll be giving all the working days as options here. Now it's time for us to drag and drop another drop down field for session timings. So here we'll be giving choices for session timings as well. So we're done creating our create timetable form. Now it's time for us to create the final form of this application, which is the make an announcement form. So the final form that we are going to create is the make an announcement form. We'll be dragging and dropping a radio field to determine our target audience for this particular announcement. That is whether the announcement is intended for the students or the teachers. Let's name our radio field as announcement 4. We'll be giving students and teachers as options here. We'll also be dragging and dropping two lookup fields for the department name and the grades. We'll also be dragging and dropping a multi-line field to gather more information. So we are done creating all the forms, which are the backbone of our Schooling 101 application. Now it's time for us to create the remaining workflows and arrange the forms by section. Now it's time for us to create a workflow for the make an announcement form. So let's choose the make an announcement form. We'll be naming the workflow here. We'll be adding a new action, and we'll be selecting delete script over here. Here we can select an event, and the choices are on load, on validate, on user input, and on success. Since we need our workflow to work after successful form submission, we'll be selecting on success here. Now it's time for us to write the delete script. Our workflow is for the student announcements, and the second part is for the ones intended at the teachers. So here we are fetching all the details and information from the add grade and add student form. And then we have dragged and dropped a send mail task where we have given the to address as rec.email1. Email 1 is the deluge name of the parent email field. And we have given the subject as mail from school, and we have given an appropriate message as well here. In the second part, we have done similar deluge coding for teachers. We are fetching information of departments and teachers here, and then we have dragged and dropped a send mail task. So let's save this workflow and move on to the next one. Now it's time for us to create the next workflow, and we'll be doing it on the create timetable form. Let's click on delete script and select on user input. We'll be selecting the grade field. Here we are fetching all the information about the grade from the add grade form, and we are mapping it with the subject field. Next workflow that we are going to do is similar to what we have done in the create timetable form. So let's choose the allot subjects to teachers form and name our workflow. Similar to how we did in the create timetable form, we'll be selecting delete script on user input this time, and we'll be selecting the grade field. Here we are fetching information from the add grade form and we are mapping it with the subject field. Let's click on save and save this particular workflow. So we are done with all our workflows. Now it's time for us to rearrange the forms and put our application to a test. Here we are at the application and we've grouped all the forms and reports into various sections here, such as admin, academics, create timetable and reports. I've already added information such as grade, subjects, teachers, students, etc. into the database. Now it's time for us to allot a particular subject to a particular teacher. So if we click on grade, only subjects that belong to that particular grade will appear here. We'll be selecting grammar and the teacher who is handling grammar is John, and we can see it here. So let's click on submit and this information will reflect on the allot subjects to teachers report. Similarly, we can click on make an announcement and we can choose whether it's for students or teachers. If it's for students, we'll be able to get the grades. And if we click on information here and we enter the information, all the students within the mailing list will receive an email with this particular announcement. Similarly, for teachers, we'll be able to select the department and all the teachers within the English department will be able to receive whatever we write in this particular information box once we click on submit. The final feature of our application is the create timetable feature. Here we'll be selecting the academic year, grade. We'll be selecting the subject, the day of the week, and the session timing. And if we click on submit, this information will reflect here automatically in the create timetable report, where the timetable report can be used as the timetable. So we have completed all the objectives of our application, as we have allotted subjects to teachers and grades, and the teachers will receive email notifications regarding the same. Make an announcement feature where we'll be able to send announcements to students as well as teachers, and all this information will be reflected in the make an announcement report. So this Schooling 101 application is the one-stop solution for timetables, announcements, and allotting subjects and teachers. It also has a database of grades, subjects, students, and teachers. To take a look at a schooling application which is much more comprehensive and has more bells and whistles, please take a look at the one in the app gallery page of Zoho Creator.
So that's it, guys. Thank you for hanging out with me all this while. We've done building our schooling application. If you want to see a schooling application with much more features, please take a look at the app gallery page of Zoho Creator. Also, feel free to check out our channel to see much more videos like the ones we have done now. We have done attendance management and education management as well, which is related to the same topic. Also, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.